But Dr. Gill and Summer, how are you guys doing this
good.
Morning?
Good morning.
All right, well, we have a couple of questions. The first one is dealing with, you know, when do you have to make that decision, or when do you know you need to make the decision about euthanizing your dog or cat?
It's always a big concern. Mm-hmm. Older animals, we start wondering about quality of life issues. It's a common question. We know they're slowing down. They don't do the things that they used to do. Vision, hearing, but I think major things we look at as far as what their quality of life is. You know, if they're in pain, you know, if they can get up and go outside and go to the bathroom, if they'll get up and eat, you know, are things that we look at when we see what their quality of life is. And talk with your veterinarian about it, and you know, all of us are going to have, them and us, are going to have bad days from time to time where they're a little sore, they don't move as well. But when I think when it gets where every day you just don't think their quality of life is there, you know, sometimes you're forced to make that decision, but certainly it's not an easy decision mm-hmm. to make.
And second question, with the heat really cranking up this time of the year, Summer actually has her paws out. That's what I was going to mm-hmm. ask. What is the danger with dogs burning their paws, especially on the asphalt during this time of the year?
They will blister their paws. That tar will actually stick to the paw, either on the pad or in between. So be careful. You know, if you think about, you know, their feet are probably tougher than ours, but still walking barefooted on the concrete or asphalt is painful. So if it's painful for us, it'd be painful for them.
So do we need to, like, test it beforehand?
Just see. You know, in general, if it's 95 degrees, you probably don't want to walk on the asphalt.
Okay.
And let them work. We like to exercise them, but if they get on the grass, they just kind of watch. Look for any redness or irritation. A lot of times they'll try to avoid that. But now, if you got a lab or something that's really excitable, they're happy to run, they don't think about it, and then you end up with blisters on the pad. So be aware that it can happen and be careful. You know, just like leaving them in cars, staying outside with no water, no shade, all of those are concerns we have as the weather starts heating up.
Okay, and the last question, also this time of the year, the fireworks stands mm-hmm. are going up, and this can be a dangerous time of the year for dog owners.
We get concerned, mainly it's just the noise. They get scared of it, so if you know your pet's scared of it, trying to get them in an interior room, you may want to talk with your veterinarian. There's sedatives, anxiety medications we can use. We see dogs that get loose, you know, they get away, they run away, and then they're lost. We also worry about them. Some dogs will chase fireworks. Kids are shooting bottle rockets, firecrackers. Dogs will try to go over there to them, and then just like they injure us, they'll injure them. So be careful. Usually you want to have your pet put up inside in a safe place before you think about shooting fireworks.
Okay. All right. Thank you so much. We will be right back in just a few minutes with your local news and weather.